I'll be just in case. Okay, please be seated. Okay, this is the first of two extraordinary meetings. This is the first one, it is on Girtrell Court. Declarations of interest, given that today meetings each relate to separate business items, members are asked to consider whether they have any disclosable, pecuniary or any of their relevant interests in connection with any matters on the agenda.
Can I propose that we have a good scene for this meeting at 5:30 p.m. Told the
Mr. Mayor, that figure 53 is actually 82. Mr. Mayor, even Labour Party members are distressed. I'll draw your attention to a comment from a Labour Party member, a Wallasey TLP, posted on the same thing as a court page. And that quote stated, they should not have tried to close this in the first place. There was a vote at Wallasey TLP to leave alone. Don't know why they did not listen to people who elected them. They brought disgrace on the Labour Party, taking on the disabled. Perhaps the Wallasey councillors could tell us tonight why they didn't listen to their members. Tonight, Mr. Mayor, I bring yet more horror stories that clearly demonstrate that this alternative provision falls well short of what has been promised. And I hope once I've made Labour members aware of this, they do the right thing for the service users as a result of our motion. Mr. Mayor, the figure 53, which we were given by the council to support closure, was incorrect. The actual figure, however, to now confirm in one move, is a massive 82, with a further 11 who can potentially take up the service. In fact, Mr. Mayor, we told our leader and cabinet member that 30% of the users, that's 31 people, had made an alternative choice, when in fact the figure is, and it remains, 11. In fact, Mr. Mayor, all these figures are borne out by the respite service scrutiny review that has recently been scoped out. They have to be less 11 chosen alternatives, so there can be no confusion about the actual factual numbers. They say in the documents, the number of families requesting to access Tollymush Road is now higher than the original number of families who originally requested respite, as I said earlier, 53. They go on to say that a lot of things have changed in numbers as we've changed just a mere slight. We've talked about an additional 29 families. That's not slight, it's an increase of 55%. Mr. Mayor, we've made council aware of these changes in numbers repeatedly, yet our words continue to fall on deaf ears. Mr. Mayor, this 10-bed unit originally describes 8 beds for respite and 2 for emergencies, given an overall total of 520 bed weeks. You know that 82 service users require 492 bed weeks, so that leaves a shortfall of 76 weeks of respite care. In an effort to overcome that shortfall of planned respite, Sanctuary Supported Living has said they will use emergency beds. However, with a caveat that should an emergency bed be required, the planned respite may be cancelled at short notice and even during respite. Their wording actually states, and I quote, we're able to book in respite into these beds under the proviso that should an emergency case be referred to us, we would need to arrange the room to make available. Therefore, parent carers would need to ensure that they are able to make these arrangements. A crisis bed should not be booked if you know that you will be unable to collect your relative at short notice. For example, a holiday before. Mr. Mayor, how can that be classed as a very much promised equal to or better? And what if the only 11 take a conservative provision? That would be 93 service users, and they would require 558 bed weeks. Mr. Mayor, that is 38 weeks more than total provision, so leaving this alternative being totally unsuitable and able to cope with demand for respite and emergency. Mr. Mayor, in summary, the existing building at Girtrell Court caters 13 respite beds, 2 emergency beds, and 5 breakdown placement beds. The alternative does not make any provision for breakdown placement, and without using emergency beds, you simply cannot cope with the existing demand for planned respite. So it cannot be described as unreliable. Mr. Mayor, it appears the council has now left to the replacement service, which is not size corrective, provides no scope for emergency demand, is inflexible, and is yet to improve. Mr. Mayor, now that I've made Labour members aware of I've written an amendment that relates to Councillor Blakey's suggestion. We can't accompany on this final stage. We have been through probably 3 years of debate in some form or other about Girtrell Court, with examination of whether the health service and other bodies can be involved. And then what struck us right through last year as a rush to change the service, when we kept saying that we need to see what the needs are and do our best to satisfy the needs of the people seeking this right to their loved ones. This is the final stage, and it's a painful stage, because at this point, on some aspects, we're going to part company with Councillor Blakey. I don't part company with him on understanding the anxiety and distress that users and people booking a service have had for the last year. It's been a long road to get to where we are, and there have been difficulties along there. There was a suggestion many months ago that the service should close and the new service would be in place quite quickly. Those ambitions proved to be, as I see it, unrealistic. They couldn't be met, and the date kept being moved. So it eventually moved from last summer to last August, and through right until now, when we have the 10 beds being provided by Sanctuary, having taken over the service in the building of Girtrell Court. When they debate about the suitability of the replacement, and there still are some anxieties about procedures for escape, but we keep being assured that the various studies by the fire authorities can recognise how that can be addressed. Mr. Mayor, in Councillor Blakely's original motion, there is discussion about halting the closure and providing a 20-bed facility at Girtrell Court and investing capital in the building. Well, for anyone who's ever had any work done in their house or home, we know how disruptive that can be. It is difficult for me to see how effectively changing a facility that does not have all suite, gutting the building, putting new wiring, and heating, and all the things you might do into a building can be achieved in a short time. So we haven't gone for let's hold things now, let's go back to status quo and carry on with Girtrell Court, because I think that is unrealistic now. Therefore, we part company on that. What I am anxious is to get clear notes, and I hope the Cabinet Member is able to give some assistance here. I have correspondence with Mr. Hopkinson on the 9th of February and the 13th of March about this very issue about emergency beds. It does appear that there was an original discussion about emergency beds being not available at short notice, being required by emergency placements. I had an email on the 13th of March which said, the carers did not want this, and we as commissioners have made sure that the provider is not going to implement this model. In other words, all the bookings would be honoured, and the company business would not be suddenly cancelling a place and putting someone else into an emergency. So I believe that's been addressed. I touch upon that in my amendment, saying council understands this matter is being addressed through discussions with the new provider. I believe it may have been finalised, now I'd like confirmation about that. So whilst I've suggested amendments to Councillor Blakely's motion, which suggests we look at Girtrell Court during the year, because there are needs, and those needs we have to see are for intermediate care and for other care in order to fulfil the problem, fulfil the issue of making sure that people can be out of Arrow Park and other places into homes or into suitable settings to reduce pressure on the health service. Because intermediate care has become difficult to provide in some settings because of changes to support living and housing benefits and other funding, we haven't got on with the intermediate care that we'd expected, as I understand it. So, Mr. Mayor, we have an amendment to Councillor Blakely, and the outcome is that we cannot agree with halting the closure and the process now, because we believe we're at such a late stage that cannot be achieved. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor. I open up to the floor.
one person.
Will be provided as and when needed. 22 people have requested alternative respite, such as Barnstondale, outdoor pursuit centre, shared lives and supported living. And this is all about choice, which I've said all along, for service users and their families. And feedback shows that these have provided new and exciting opportunities for people who previously only had a virtual call to whether they wanted it or not. It must also be noted that there are 50 other people who use alternative provision. The issue around cancellation at short notice was sorted out, as Councillor Blakely is aware, and I can confirm to Councillor Gilchrist that that is the case. I don't accept that Council made a wrong decision, and the people who cause most distress and trauma to service users are the opposition, who keep calling for special Council meetings before the new service is even opened. It's an absolute disgrace.
Before the old service is closed. Is that the date? Can you confirm that?
We're taking our time and we are doing it right. I don't believe that even with a full refurbishment, the virtual court would be right for everyone, because they still wouldn't have the choice that they deserved. And to say we need 20 beds is a nonsense. I thank the Lib Dems for trying to soften the motion and actually realising the stage we're at in the procedure. The scrutiny review is obviously going to take feedback from service users, and I'm sorry really that Councillor McLaughlin is here to confirm that. I echo what the amendment says, that thanks should go to the service users and members of the public who fought to ensure that individual needs had to be recognised and provided for with services that needed developing. The new service is better.
No, it's not.
It's choice. And once it opens, I think that people will really appreciate the new surroundings. They're getting choice of furnishings and decor. And Mr. Mayor, I won't be voting for the Conservative amendment motion. I'll be voting against both that and, I'm afraid, the Lib Dem amendment as well.
Scrutiny is too late,
Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I actually wasn't going to speak in this. I was going to speak in this debate until I heard the cabinet member attacking Councillor Blakely. And also this issue. And I wanted to put on record my thanks, and I think this group's thanks to Councillor Blakely for ensuring that this has been kept in the public's mind. Things alone to add in terms of families and service users, because we've kept this issue alive. But the people who've had to put up with this, the delays that have been mentioned by Councillor Blakely and Councillor Gilchrist, the way families have been treated, are the families and the service users. And frankly, the way they have been treated has been shocking. And I think the very fact that the Labour Party attacked Councillor Blakely for bringing that to their attention is more of an insight into how the Labour Party now operates in this council chamber than it is on the fact that we've had to call these special council meetings for it to be discussed. Can I just add that apparently, according to the cabinet member and to all the comments that were made across, it's okay to play with numbers. So you can say there's this number, that number, and the rest of it. But I'm looking up at the gallery.
Labour people can't see us.
And we're talking about people. This is not about pretending to manipulate numbers one way or the other. It's about people. And the way that people from families from Girtrell Court have been treated is nothing short of disgraceful. And I thought we had gone beyond this idea that a cabinet member gets up and starts saying, the trouble with this is the families don't know what's good for them and they're going to care for them. And that's exactly what was said. listened to what the service users and families are saying and responded to that, rather than making a big appeal about being unprepared to listen to what residents, families and service users have said. It's about time this administration started listening.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I do find it actually somewhat ironic. seen Girtrell being invested in, and its capability is expanded to enable the NHS to use the centre on a joint basis for patients who either do not need hospital care or who are being prepared for hospital discharge following treatment. This option would have delivered a double benefit. The first benefit would have been improved facilities for respite users, and the second benefit would have been a much needed facility to alleviate the bed blocking crisis within our local hospitals. Unfortunately, that plan never came to fruition, and the director for DAS announced that Girtrell Court would close in order to save, and this was a revised budgetary figure of £155,000. Obviously, there was lots of opposition to that proposal from service users, carers, family members, trade unions and elected members. Somewhere along the way, faced with the amount of opposition to this proposal, the emphasis has suddenly changed from a cost-cutting exercise to a suggestion that service users were demanding more choice. Elected members could find very full evidence of this, and so requested figures to support that claim. We were told that of 105 service users, only 55 still required bed-based respite services. The other 15 had chosen other options. This was contrary to the information that was being told by us, told by service users and their carers. As members are aware, this situation has been ongoing for some time. We have always maintained that Girtrell Court is a clear choice for the vast majority of service users. It has recently been confirmed by Secretary of Supported Living and the Director of DAS that 82 service users have requested bed-based respite service. It has also been confirmed that 11 service users are currently denied the service but are still eligible to access the service if they so wish. This gives a potential 93 service users who will move from a 20-bed facility to a 10-bed facility with no guarantee that their respite will not be cancelled at short notice or during their respite period. Mr Mayor, I refer to the questions and answers session that took place between service users and Sanctuary Supported Living. One of the questions, will everyone's allocation of respite still be accommodated? Is there enough capability? The answer, we do not anticipate a vast shortfall in respite provision, but will ensure that everyone is provided with the relevant information and advice of other options utilise their full allocation of respite. And obviously they don't want other options. Yes, Mr Mayor, I will finish you. Another question.
Councillor Bailey, please sit down, but we did say that we were going to finish tonight by our responsibility and democratically announced at past 5, but we're going well beyond that. You please sit down.
It didn't start until 6 minutes past.
Do you want to have a look at my nerves?
Although it did
It's only 11 accused alternatives, and that is a fact, and there they are here. This is the best place to be. I was accused of supporting them. Two chosen care for residential care, one's chosen Seacombe House, one she advised, one new vacant, one the fairness, and 11 declined service. That is 11 people chose alternatives. And Councillor Jones said she's glad that we welcomed that it was about choice. Yes, we originally started about £155,000. You guys over there quickly twisted that to it's about choice. It is about choice. 18 people have chosen care for both. They've got to be foisted off to another service because their choice doesn't matter. The choice of the 11 does. The choice of the 11 to keep the service matters. But the 82 who chosen it, they say it doesn't matter to you, does it? Their choice is immaterial. Absolutely immaterial. And as for Councillor Davis, you know, fancy laying the blame on the Conservatives. And try to protect more and more people. But we're standing up and blaming this group. We're keeping this the fucking guards. And we're saying, you know, we're acting outrageously in doing so. We hear the same old rhetoric about the government. The government did not choose. Mr. Mayor, the government did not choose to close Girtrell Court. The government did not choose to spend £270,000 on a newspaper that nobody wants.
As usual, can we keep quiet?
Mr. Mayor,
I'm
18 for, 40 against, and four abstentions. That's clearly lost. Thank you very much, councillors. That concludes the business of the first extraordinary meeting.
Shame.
Shame on you.